Before commissioning the water project, the State Minister of Water and Environment, Aisha Sekindi, toured the water tanks to check the quality of the water.
Project fits directly into the government vision of ensuring that each and every village in this country has a safe water source. Under NDP 3, rural water supply sub-program contributes to the Human Capital Development Program objectives of improving population health, safety and management.
The water project, which has 418 taps, 36 public stands and 10 public kiosks, will serve over 10 villages.
The chlorination unit does not need any external energy source for it to actually to work, but it utilizes the energy within the transmission line to actually energize it so that it's able to pump chlorine back into the line.
These villages include Kakinga, Kanara, Kitosi, Rakahungu Town Council, Buhinga Sub-County, among others, that will benefit from this clean water project. The minister handed over the water project to National Water and Sewerage Corporation to take charge of the operations and requested them to increase water tariffs to enable residents access clean water at a low cost.
Thank you so much.
As National Water, our target is to ensure that we have 100% service coverage, to ensure that every customer in all the areas we are in are fully covered with water. So this is a progress in the right direction for the people of Kamwenge.
Residents and local leaders have hailed the government for extending clean water in rural areas, saying they have been trekking long distances to access clean water.
That one will reduce on the diseases, waterborne diseases within the communities. As a result, people will be able to save money they would spend for treatment, and they can be able to invest the money into other priority areas of need at the household level.
We have drinking water from dirty wells, but now, since we have got clean water, we are going to be cooking it and then drinking clean water. The project is expected to spend 20 years providing clean water to the residents, who have been also urged to maintain the operationalization of the system. Report by Antonia Twine for the news.